Good noon, my dear students. I'm here with one more new topic from community medicine, that is under 5 clinics. You might have seen this question appearing in most of the university examination as a part of 5-mark question or as a part of 1-mark question. And even this question is asked lot many times in Viva and practicals when you take up community medicine examination. So under 5 clinics, one of the very important topics in this preventive and social medicine. So let's study the salient features of under 5 clinics in today's class. So the overview of this particular class mainly contains introduction, objectives and goals of this under 5 clinic, and what are the different components of under 5 clinic, activities and their strategies, and finally the summary. So first, let's see introduction part of this under 5 clinics. So as you can see here, the first 5 years of life form the foundation of child's physical and mental growth and development. So this first 5 years of life is crucial for the growth of any child if you take into consideration. Lot many studies have shown that the mortality and morbidity is very high in this particular age group, and that too the deaths caused by pneumonia and diarrhea are high in under 5 children. The Department of Health established the under 5 clinic program to address this problem, that is to bring down the mortality and morbidity in this age group of children, that is under 5. So what are the components of this under 5 clinic? Please follow the diagram here. So you can see that there are 5 different components here. You can see that there is outer triangle which is pointed upwards and inside triangle which is pointed downwards. And because of this, there are 4 components inside, and on top of this triangle, there is the 5th component. So you can see here that the 5 important components are care and illness for the child, which is mainly under 5, monitoring the growth of the child, providing preventive care for the child, health education for the mother and family regarding the child's care and child health, and last but not the least is the family planning. So what are the 5 important components of under 5 clinic? It includes care and illness, monitoring the growth, preventive care, family planning, and health education. So after knowing the components of under 5 clinics, let me explain you what are the program objectives and goals. There are 2 main objectives and goals for this program. What is that first one? As the component said, monitor the growth and development of the child until 5 years of age. Up to 1 year, at least monthly once, you have to monitor the weight and height or the length, that we call it as crown hill length of the child, and also the head circumference to know whether they are going for malnutrition or whether their development is up to normal or not. After 1 year of age, up to 5 years, at least once in 4 months or 3 months, you need to check their height, their weight, midarm circumference, chest circumference, and head circumference too. If there is any deviation from normal, it means that the child is going for malnutrition or it is suffering from developmental delay. So the second important program objective or the goal is to identify factors that may hinder the growth and development of the child. So there are many factors which may hamper the growth of the child who are under 5. So it is an opportunity for you sitting in under 5 clinic as a service provider, healthcare service provider, to identify those factors which are hampering the growth of the child, and you can see to it that they have their proper growth and development in the first 5 years of life. So I repeat, the objectives and goals of this program are mainly 2. First one is to monitor the growth and development of the child in between up to the 5 years of life, and the second one is to identify factors that may hinder the growth and development of the child. With this knowledge, let us see what are the activities and strategies in these under 5 clinics. The first one is to see the height and weight of the child up to 5 years of age. So as I've already told you, up to 1 year you call it as crown hill length, and also you should monitor the weight and also head circumference. There are certain parameters. They say at birth the child should be 2.5 kgs, by 6 months the weight should at least double, and by 1 year of life it should triple. Similarly, the length, they say that at birth it would be around 45 centimeters, which would double almost by the year of 1 year, like that. It keeps on going. So at least by the year of 1 year, the child will be around 75 centimeters minimum. So if you take in head circumference into consideration, any newborn child who is at term can have the head circumference of 33 to 35 centimeters. So starting from there, up to 5 years of life, you keep monitoring the child with the help of growth charts. There are many growth charts available, ICDS growth charts or Anganwadi growth charts, which has color coding in it. Those who fall into green line are very safe, yellow they are bit danger, and who fall into red zone are the one who are having severe malnutrition. And there are other charts available like IAP charts, WHO charts, etc. So the second important activity under this is recording the immunization process, vitamin supplementation, deworming and feeding. See, let me take one by one. Let me explain a word or two about each subheading. Immunization, you know that there is a proper immunization schedule, either universal immunization schedule, IAP schedule. Sometimes you will merge both to know what are optional vaccines, what are regular vaccines. Starting from birth up to 15 years of life, there is a proper schedule which needs to be followed. You want to know whether the child is immunized up to date or not, so you can record it over there. For example, 9 months old child comes to your under 5 clinic, you should note that the child would have got BCG at birth, OPV at birth, hepatitis B at birth, pentavalent, rotavac, and IPV, OPV at 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5 months of life. And if in case they're taking optional vaccines, a pneumonia vaccine would also been have given to the child. And after 6 months, if you're considering optional vaccines, the child would have taken typhoid vaccine, or the child would have also taken flu vaccine. At 9 months, the child would have taken MMR or MR vaccine along with vitamin A. So if these many things are done, then you call it as immunization up to date. Otherwise, the child is lagging behind, and you can take this opportunity to immunize the child. Vitamin supplementation. You know that you should give vitamin A prophylaxis to each and every child. For every 6 months, starting from 9 months, at least up to 3 years, and in government setup they go up to 5 years. Deworming, albendazole every 6 months once need to be given to every child which is aged above 1 year. Feeding, up to 6 months you should take breastfeeding into consideration, and after exclusive breastfeeding up to 6 months. After 6 months you add complementary feeding along with breastfeeding. Provide IEC materials for them, to provide health education, provide a safe and learning oriented environment for the child, and monitoring and evaluation. So finally, I would summarize now. Under 5 clinic is a very important project of the health department to bring down the mortality and morbidity of child aged less than 5 years of life. So this has got 5 important components: care and illness for the child, family planning, preventive care, growth monitoring. Which is missed here is the health education component. So these 5 components are given lot of importance in under 5 clinics. It is also an opportunity to monitor the height and weight, to immunize the child, to provide vitamin supplementation, to deworm, and to give proper advice on exclusive breastfeeding till 6 months, and complementary feeding along with breastfeeding after 6 months. To make use of IEC materials like posters, charts, and toys to provide good health education, to provide safe and learning process provision of a safe and learning environment over there, and to monitor and evaluate the project which you have brought into action in under 5 clinic. So that's all about under 5 clinic. Thank you.